Welcome to Child of the Light, I'm your host lostwolfe, and we're on the main menu for a rare change, because we've finished the game and I want to show you the downloadable content, but the way you activate some of the downloadable content is a little bit weird and wacky and out there. So there are six pieces of downloadables, maybe seven downloadable content pieces in total. I want to say four of them. Yeah, it is four, actually. So, there's seven pieces of content. Four of them are a thing is like Oculi, so it's like a tumbled pack, and then a rough pack, and then a brilliant pack. And then there's a Stardust pack, and that's of very little consequence. I would not, if I were you, buy that at all. But there are two dresses and a little extra story. It's not a very long extra story, but we're going to go do that together. So to get the dresses to work, you need to actually go into your options here, and you need to actually hit Aurora's dress over here. Now there's two dresses that you can have. One is Inked Aurora, and the other one is Princess of the Wind. If you go Inked Aurora, and you back out, and you continue, you get, she looks like this. Essentially, let's get her there where you can see her. That's Antor, she's sort of black and white. Now one of these, I don't remember which one it is, but one of these will give you a spell as well. A slightly different way of doing healing, I believe it is. Also, when I finished the game, I ended up with extra skills, two extra skills, which I haven't allocated, so let's do that. You, oh right, also you don't have your party, so you're gonna go recollect your party again. It isn't the new game, but you have to go and collect your party all over again, so that is not gonna happen. Let's bail out to the main menu. Yes. Wow, loud. The other one, the other dress, is over here. And this is Princess of the Wild Wind. Princess of the Wind. And if we continue, this is what that looks like. It's sort of a blue dress. Much like the original dress, not quite the same though. Okay, so what I'm gonna do, I'm gonna bail us out of here real quick like. You can't, unfortunately, do this from here. If you go Aurora and you try and change her dress, you'll see there that it's just grayed out, which is silly, but it's Ubisoft, so I'm not even remotely surprised. Okay. Now, the next thing that we're going to do is we are going to do the story. The last little bit of the story, I should say. Oh, this is going to be a silly fight. Oh, really? I didn't know that Oengus was with me. Does that mean I have access to everyone? Oh, I do. Well, I'm a little weirded out now. I guess we'll slash. And you can Katakita Claws and we'll just beat these people. Won't take very long. There we go. I didn't actually mean to get into combat like that. I am in fact trying to avoid combat. If I go down here, let's hop down and run. If you go here, there's a spot called the Tree of Thorns, which of course we visited very early on in the game. And right over there, we've got a little guy hanging out. This is perfect in all types of weather, and best spot in Lemuria to gaze. Just look around for days and days. I think that's about all of his lines. What a view! This is my favorite spot too. I could stay here forever. Perfect in all types of weather. So, just before I talk to him, this is the other DLC that matters. It's called the Golem Pack, I believe. And what it really does is it gives you a tiny little extra quest. Now, if you had bought this back when it was on pre-order, it wasn't a pre-order. If you bought the special edition bundle or whatever it was, you would have gotten all these things together. But they're now selling this stuff separately. So if you want to get this, it's part of the Golem Pack. I didn't install this when we were playing the game because I don't think of this sort of stuff as actually part of the game. I think of it as just a little extra. But if you had started off the game and you'd played it through, you would have picked him up very early and you'd have seen all his responses. We're not going to see all his responses, unfortunately, because we're just going to do his quest. I find it... Oh, I can actually... Oh, goodness. Then that must cost two... Oh, right. I'm silly. So I do actually have access to all my people. Okay, so let's take his quest. Pardon me, do you need help? Not at all. You seem to be rather disassembled. Just a simple fall. I can take care of myself. You're small and round. Are you my brother? Ah, Igniculus. Your chest, arms, and legs are where? Oh, and the thorns. Three pieces split from one another. That state of affairs is not ideal. Atop the palace of Lemuria I once stood. The queen and knight toppled me down. Once I decide to put myself together for good, I go and knock her to the ground. So then do it. Pull yourself together. Not right now. I'm busy enjoying the weather. Why are you so stubborn? Waiting for a miracle? Silly. Igniculus, we carry him to find his three pieces. I hope he won't get dizzy. Anyway, so you pick him up and it's head of the golem. If you then obviously go into inventory, you will see there that we have the head of the golem and we have the golem's plight. That's what it's called. It's called the golem's plight. Find the three missing parts of the golem in the thorns, then reassemble him. This isn't especially difficult. Here's the spot where you'll be looking the thorns. There we go. Are those his arms? Yes, they are. We can pick them up. Two of the golem's bones. Arms of the golem. Ow. And then I believe that, there we go. Other golem pieces. The likelihood of successful assembly increases. And we got the torso of the golem. And the last piece is... Oh, not here. Oops. Silly me. I'm having that foreground background thing where I look at it and I can't quite tell what is foreground and what is not. Up we go. And through. Here on the ground. Golem pieces have been found. And we get his legs and now he's all assembled. Let the golem unify. My body I have now occupy. I can grasp my club again. My whole life alone. I needed no other. Yet, to form a man's stone must be shaped by a sculptor. Princess. Aurora, please, sir. Aurora, I offer my services. I would not accept such a gift, I demur. They are yours to do with as you wish. What is this? I insist. Well, how about this? You accompany me into the palace's midst. On a visit to the queen? Sounds mean. I'm keen. Okay, so he joins, the golem has joined the party. And of course from this point outward, he would go with you wherever you went. So let's just very quickly look at him. In contrast with everyone else, he is level 12, of course, because you would have picked him up at about that level. His big thing is defense and strength and magic defense. So he'd be sort of like a tanky kind of guy. He has three trees, obviously. This tree over here is shock, which is the one I am inclined to take. Yeah, this would be the one I would take if I were playing from scratch and with him. And then the other tree here is regenerate. Does that regenerate? Oh, right, yeah. Actually, I would probably take regenerate because I like that kind of thing more. Where is the top of his tree? Yeah, I'd probably take the regenerate tree. And then the last tree, of course, is here, which is defend. Okay, so let's give him regenerate. So, I'm going to get into a super quick fight, just so you can see what he's like. Let's grab all of this here. Oh, I was going along with it. There is, I think, a fight right about here. So he is sort of a Noengus stand-in that happens a lot earlier than Noengus himself. So he looks like this. He's a lot smaller, obviously, in-game. And obviously I got Smash, I got Regenerate, and I got Defend. I don't think that we're going to have a serious problem here. We're just going to smash everyone. There we go. And we'll kill you. Just to sort of show what his regenerate looks like. There we go. He healed 15. Right. Did you ever see creatures like these? A tree to the left, a boulder to the right. 300 years I stood watch. The courtyard was all on my side. Right, I'm gonna head. Okay, just one more very quick thing. If you don't start New Game Plus, you get access to everything as you were. So we're going to travel to the altar real quick. And I'm going to bail out. Because I want to show you... I should actually just show you. We've seen party, we've seen your skills. Your inventory with your oculi sticks around. Your inventory with all your stuff sticks around. We've seen that already. You get your map of Lemuria, your confessions are all still there. You got options, of course. I'm going to quit the main menu very briefly. One additional thing is that there is a New Game Plus. And if you start New Game Plus, I'm inclined to believe it wipes everything. You get to keep your items, but not your companions, and not your collectibles. So let's just bail. If I do New Game Plus, it's probably going to want me to put in a new... It's going to clear all the data, so I just want to very quickly see if I can get you a New Game Plus from the main menu. I don't think that will happen that way. Let's go back to the main menu. Okay, so I just spent like 5 minutes going through the introduction and everything. It turns out that making a new file doesn't work the way I thought it did. So if you hit New Game Plus... New Game Plus resets the story to the beginning with harder foes, but lets you keep current character upgrades. So it lets you keep basically everything, but the story starts over again, and the levels are a lot harder because they start at 45, like I said when we were still playing the game. Anyway, that's it. That's the end of Child of Light. We're going to start something new soon. Buckle in. I have no idea what it is going to be, but it should be fun. And that's where we're going to end off for tonight. Have a wonderful evening, and I shall see you all soon. Good night for now, folks.